This is WTCN-TV, Metro Media 11.
And now, the Stuart A. Lindman News.
That's the news.
Good heavens!
Live from Channel 11 in the Twin Cities.
This is the 5:30 edition of News Center 11.
C-A-R-E. Twin Cities' fastest growing. KARE 11 News.
Welcome back to KARE 11's 70th anniversary special. We have had a lot of on-air personalities over the year at our station, and every one of them hope to connect on some level with the community.
But there is one person in particular that seemed to have hit a special chord with viewers. And in the 20 years he was here, you could say everything changed for our station.
Now, the Twin Cities' most watched newscast, News 11. With Paul Majors.
There was a time when Paul Majors was one of the top local news anchors in the country.
We do have some breaking news to report.
But not right away.
Good evening. President Clinton is promising he'll deliver federal dollars.
When Majors showed up in the Twin Cities in 1983, the 10 o'clock newscast on Channel 11 was in fourth place, far behind WCCO and KSTP and Star Trek reruns on Channel 9.
What bothered me about it was there were only 12 episodes of the original program. So people would rather watch an episode of Star Trek for the 150th time rather than watch us. I remember walking into the boss, Tom Kirby, and saying, you know, it would actually be cheaper if we just went to the people's homes who were watching and read them the news in their living room rather than go to the expense of broadcasting.
Now, from the action center of the Twin Cities, News 11 with Paul Majors.
What happened after that is nothing short of a TV news miracle, thanks in part to Majors, Diana Pierce, and so many others, plus strong primetime programming by NBC. Channel 11's rise in the news ratings was fast and furious.
This is really spectacular.
The thing that cemented the deal was the tornado.
It put KARE on the map.
And I think it created a great deal of trust that we became the station to turn to.
And that's what happened.
For my career, my best years were at KARE. My most enjoyable, interesting years were at KARE.
And he had a lot of fun leading the KARE news team.
Oh, the town loves Halloween.
Growing up in a large family and being the youngest, Paul loved pranks. He pulled off his share. He reveled in the camaraderie of the newsroom. And that genuine love for each other was how KARE's audience connected.
There was just a lack of pretentiousness. I always used to hear that about CCO, that they were pretty pretentious. And I have to agree.
But Paul was the consummate pro. He knew the news inside and out, and that's what made him the best. He was trustworthy, authentic, and empathetic. And when he left KARE in 2003, he left with one story that he could not let go.
The story that touched me the most in the 20 years I've been here was the kidnapping, the abduction of Jacob Wetterling.
Paul Majors has been with us from the beginning.
We finally have answers to nearly three decades of questions surrounding the disappearance of Jacob Wetterling.
When his body was found in 2016, what was your reaction?
Boy, like it is right now, I remember just staring at what I was reading. I was relieved for Jacob's parents. I was relieved for Patty Wetterling, that there's some bit of closure. God, every time I think about it, I get emotional.
Just the innocence of kids out on a country road.
Three boys riding their bikes after they go to the video store?
Yeah.
And that happens? That's the story that changed me.
Yeah.
Made me more empathetic.
Hello and welcome to your CBSLA.com news brief. I'm Paul Majors.
Paul left KARE for CBS in Los Angeles in December of 2003. He says the culture in the LA newsroom was terrible. Every man for himself.
When I first got there for that first year, I would lie awake. I would say out loud, what have I done? Feeling sorry for myself. Like, why is this so messed up?
Paul anchored at KCBS in LA for 13 years before retiring in 2017. It was at that time he underwent treatment for alcoholism, a battle he's still winning today. Nowadays, Paul spends his time in California, enjoying retirement and his family. He will turn 70 next year, and he looks back at his TV career in Minnesota with heartfelt appreciation.
I would describe it as the most rewarding and enjoyable 20 years of my career. Easily.